Hello children, today again we are going to start with our science second video of the third chapter, that is the fiber to fabric. I hope you have understood the previous video and there are no doubts. So we did in the last class, we have done with the types of fibers, natural fibers. We have started with the wool, the characteristics, sources, in that different types and their uses. So today we are going to move little bit ahead in this. So the wool yielding animals bears a thick coat of hair called fleece. Hair. Now what is hair? Hair in mammals, the characteristic thread-like outgrowth of the outer layer of the skin that forms the animal coat or the fur. Fleece is nothing but it's a woolly covering of a sheep or a goat. Now this fleece are of two types. They are coarse bare hair and the fine soft under hair, which is very close to the skin. The fine soft under hair are supposed to be the fine quality. Now when I say coarse beard, but naturally you must have not understood what is the main difference between the fine soft under hair and coarse beard hair. Coarse beard hair, the single strand of the hair is slightly thick as compared to the soft under hair. Being slightly thick, the texture is somewhat rough, and hence the second type, that is a fine soft under hair, is more preferred over the coarse beard hair. There are certain breeds of sheep which possess only fine under hair, so their parents are specially chosen to give birth to sheep which have only soft under hair. Now what is done actually to obtain only the soft under hair type fleece? The scientists develop certain breeds. Now these breeds are developed by crossing their parents, that is the parents which are having good quality of fur, good color of fur. Now such parents are crossed, and then their children or the offspring which is produced is having a soft under hair or the good quality of fleece. This is called as a selective breeding. So definition is process of selecting parents for obtaining special characters in their offspring is termed as a selective breeding. So animals from which wool can be obtained are bred to obtain wool on large scale. This process is called as a rearing. So these animals are reared to obtain wool. So the sheep and the wool obtaining animals, they all are herbivore animals, that is they feed on grass and leaves, but apart from this they are also given some nutritious diet like mixtures of pulses, corn, jowar, etc., so that they develop good quality and thick fleece. Now we'll move on to see the production of wool. Process of obtaining wool, processing of wool, or you can say production of wool. The step first in this is shearing. The process of removal of fleece from an animal is called as shearing. The sheep is shorn annually in early summer so that they don't feel the heat. The hair of the sheep grows again before the onset of winter and protects them from the cold weather. Shearing does not hurt the sheep because the uppermost layer of the skin of sheep is dead, and this shearing is done manually using a razor with a special clippers, or it can be done with the machines. After this, the removed fleece is now sent for the second step, that is the scoring. The process of washing of fleece in tanks to remove grease, dust, dirt from it is called as scouring. The fleece is thoroughly cleaned by washing with soap or detergent and lots of water in the tank. The hair contains lanolin, that is a natural oil, which also gets removed. Nowadays, the scouring is done by machines. With this, now the next step will be moving. Now it's step 3, that is grading and sorting. Grading is breaking up of fleece based on overall quality of wool. The wool is separated or sorted into various categories on the basis of its quality. The quality here is length, texture, color, and easy to dye. The fleece is combed to remove burrs, which are called as tiny knots, which are formed in the fleece or the hair. Fewer the burrs, better the quality of wool. Now next is the step 4, that is dyeing and drying. Natural fleece is either white, black, brown in color. They can be dyed with various colors. Roller machines squeezes excess water from the fleece, but the fleece is not allowed to dry completely. Then the wool is weighed and packed into bales. The bales are transported to mills where they are processed further. Now next step is the step 5, that is making of yarn or spinning. So after drying, the color fibers are combed, straightened so that they can be rolled into yarn. Now this is called as carding, that is preparing the wool for spinning. After carding, fibers are twisted and turned to form yarns in spinning machines. The wool is then woven and knitted into fabric. If you observe here, you can see the individual fibers. Now these individual fibers are twisted to form this yarn. And many of these yarns are then woven to form this fabric. In the similar way, here in a short, it's fiber, they are spinning, it's getting converted to yarn. Yarn, by weaving or knitting, it gets converted into a fabric. Now, students, this is a small scale industry, that is wool production or wool processing, whatever it is done. In this small scale industry, there are many workers who are working. And these workers are many a time exposed to few kinds of infections or certain diseases. Now these are called as occupational hazards. So now we are going to see what are the health hazards which the workers are facing when they are working in the wood production. The first is workers are exposed to large number of chemicals, so they experience allergic problems and respiratory disorders. Second, workers get infected by anthrax disease caused by Bacillus anthracis, which is a bacterial disease. Also cause fatal blood disease, which is a Sauter's disease. So these three different types of infection or diseases are caused when they are exposed to the different chemicals in the wool processing. But nowadays, many preventive measures or vaccination is done, and hence they are safe in this industry. So with this, I'll stop my video today and will continue in the next video for the next portion. I hope you must have understood whatever we have done up till now. If you have any query, please be free to ask. Thank you, children.